Hey guys, Justin Bryant here from selfmadesuccess.com, and I want to do a comparison of two very popular hosting services, Bluehost and HostGator. Okay, I'm going to do a Bluehost versus HostGator complete comparison. I'm going to be comparing things like Cpanel, customer support, uptime, performance, SEO, extra features, email, things like that. I'm going to go over every part of it. I've gotten a lot of feedback that people love my comparisons in some of my other videos. I did Buffer versus Hootsuite. I did AWeber versus GetResponse. So now every website owner and every entrepreneur should have some kind of WordPress site, and obviously you need hosting for that. Bluehost and HostGator are two of the best to start out with, and you probably see them all over the place, and it's hard to tell which one is better than the other. So through my experiences and through the constant research I've done on other website owners and what they've said, through honest reviews, not just people that are trying to sell affiliate links and things like that, this is a complete honest comparison. I'm not going to have an affiliate link for this. I'm not going to sell you anything. This is just for your purpose of figuring out which one is best for you, okay? So first off, we're going to go with the cPanel. As far as the cPanel goes, it's basically a tie, okay? They have both very navigable cPanels that are easy to manage, easy to find what you need. They have different applications and features. They both have one-click WordPress installation, which is the main thing you need. You know, you can set up your email, set up anything in there very easily, and both of them do use cPanel, and they're both very similar. So I wouldn't worry too much about making a decision based on that, because it's about a tie. Second, customer support. Obviously, with hosting, things can happen. Hosting is what keeps your website up and running. You need to have good customer support. Okay, both of them have 24/7, 365 day a year phone support that is US based. They both have live chat pretty much all day long. They both have email support and even self-help support pages where they have tutorials and setup pages to help you do it yourself. If you don't want to, you know, talk to somebody, you can go through their tutorials first. So basically, they put a high emphasis on customer support between Bluehost and HostGator both. So with that, it's another tie. Then we get to pricing. Okay, pricing is obviously very important. If you're starting out your first website or your first business, then you want to keep the cost down, and you're not going to need a whole lot of, you know, you're not going to need a whole lot of server space. You're not going to need your own dedicated servers yet. You're not going to need a bunch of expensive things. So Bluehost uses yearly plans. Some people like that better, some people don't. HostGator offers monthly, and you know, as you can tell by the prices, they're very similar. You might save a few cents by going with HostGator. So if you look at that, then you know they have very similar packages, but you might see that on the hatchling plan versus the starter, HostGator has unlimited disk space, and it's, you know, less than 30 cents cheaper. But if every cent counts when you're starting a business, which it does for a lot of people, then I gotta go with HostGator on this by a small margin. Okay, so HostGator wins the pricing. And next we're gonna go over uptime. Okay, so uptime, if you don't know what that is, uptime is, you know, when your website is live, people are able to go to it, click on it, read your post, go through your pages, things like that. Downtime is when your site doesn't work, or there's an error when people try to go to your site. They can't click on your pages, they can't read your posts, they can't go through it. And a lot of times when you use shared servers and things like that, downtime can be a problem depending on your hosting company. So HostGator offers a 99.9% uptime guarantee. From what I've seen and from what I've used, they're very good on that promise. And I've never heard anybody complain about a HostGator uptime problem. And so Bluehost has hosted a lot of websites that tend to have more downtime than HostGator. They don't really have the same guarantee. So I'm going to have to go with HostGator. Although I have had a bad incident or two with HostGator where they would shut down my site because it would get slow because of a plugin or something like that. So do be careful about that. But for the most part, HostGator will probably have much better uptime and than Bluehost. As far as speed and performance, it's very close. Again, you know, both of these companies are very close in pretty much all categories, but Bluehost tends to have a slightly better server response time, page load time, and time to first bit, which is when you first load a page as a new visitor to a site that you've never been to. And although some people claim to have better luck with HostGator, Bluehost tends to have a little bit better performance, I think, and I think it'll load your pages a little bit faster, although it can vary. Another problem with this is HostGator has trouble with things like plugins for SEO purposes. So maybe even some people have better load time with HostGator starting out, but Bluehost actually doesn't have as many problems with like the Yoast SEO plugin or W3 Total Cache. If you don't know what those are two of the most important plugins for your WordPress site, because they help you SEO it, they help you rank better, and they help you get more traffic and speed up your site. But HostGator has trouble integrating those into their hosting for your sites, and they can actually slow down your sites and make them mess up. And when you go to support about it, they tell you to uninstall those plugins. So that could be a problem for your SEO purposes, which leads me to the next part, SEO integration. HostGator has problems with those plugins that I just mentioned. The Yoast SEO plugin is very important for meta descriptions, meta tags, titles, RSS, things like that, that will help your site better rank. It'll also teach you to rank your blog post better by showing you how to do on-page SEO, and it has a little checklist at the bottom of each post that you can go through for that. W3 Total Cache, it caches your site. It optimizes your site, it makes it faster, it makes it perform better, and keeps your load times low, okay? Both of those are two of the most important ones for all websites on WordPress, and HostGator has problems with both of those, and support will tell you the same thing. So if you have trouble with your HostGator hosting, I don't know very good alternatives for those plugins, but you'll just have to deal with that if you go with HostGator. So Bluehost wins SEO. Next, email features. Obviously, it's good to have an email that is hosted through your website that has your website name. So if your name is Johnny, you'll be like johnny@yourdomain.com. So you want to be able to use your domain as your email. It looks more professional and it shows people where you're from. Both offer unlimited email accounts, email access from any device, and email forwarding for your website's domain. So I can't pick between them. They're pretty much a dead tie in email features. So as far as extra features for Bluehost versus HostGator, Bluehost offers a free domain and probably more promotions and coupon codes than HostGator. I know HostGator gets a lot of promotion, but I see a lot more Bluehost promotions, coupon codes, things like that for cheaper rates than I do for HostGator. maybe that's just the sites I go on, maybe not. But when it comes to getting a discount on Bluehost, you know, you're going to find a lot of offers that can apply to a whole year instead of, you know, HostGator does like a 1 cent first month for their stuff, but that only lasts you a month. So you might get a better promotion for long term using Bluehost. And the free domain is great too. You know, I showed you that the pricing is a little bit better through HostGator, but when you factor in the coupon codes and the promotions and the free domain, a free domain can cost you a lot of money. It can be fairly cheap, depending on the domain, but either way, just a cheap domain is still $15 or $20 a year, so that if you tack that on to the monthly rate of the pricing, Bluehost would actually have better pricing than HostGator if you factor that in. So, in the long run, you may save more money as well as time using Bluehost, because you would also have the free domain set up through Bluehost, so you would be able to skip a step in the setup process of putting your domain, hosting, and WordPress site all together when you start your website from scratch. So on top of that, you know, like I said, you would save time because of annual billing. Another thing I hated about HostGator is the way their billing was kind of set up. Obviously, with hosting companies, a lot of times they don't do automatic charges. You actually go there and pay the bill when it's due. But it's kind of annoying at the end of every month, you always have to go to HostGator, do that, and then you get all these emails about if it's overdue or not or whatever. And it's just annoying, and personally, the annual billing would be better, I think. And, you know, maybe not for you, maybe you don't want to pay it much at one time, but, you know, on a month-to-month basis, it'll save you time from having to pay a bill every time. And, like I said, the free domain makes the setup easier because the domain's already in Bluehost. And, Bluehost also offers automated weekly backups for free. HostGator charges $15 for the same service, so, all in all, extra features, included. Bluehost is the winner of that. So, closing notes, HostGator tends to disable sites that have performance problems sometimes. If you've ever read the article that Juice DeValk did on Yoast.com, if you know what Yoast.com is, or if you don't, Yoast.com is one of the top SEO sites around that I know of in the world, actually. So, when it comes to SEO or needing to know more about SEO and optimizing your site, Yoast is the place to go. And he does not approve of HostGator because of some of the they have done shady things in the past for his customers. And obviously I do have personal experience with that. They have shut down my site a few times because of just weird things that without notice. So, be careful of that, although they may be the better option for you, depending on how you view this comparison. Watch out for things like that, and make sure you don't let support or anybody take advantage of you. Make sure you know exactly what's going on and why they may shut down your site if they do that. But if you get the problem worked out quickly, they'll get your site live again very quickly. So, you know, that's how it goes. On top of that, you know, there's really no problems I have with HostGator. Just one experience, so I don't want to sound biased or anything. I didn't have any problems like that with Bluehost, but Bluehost does have, you know, their own deal, and they're a little bit different from HostGator. So the verdict between HostGator and Bluehost would be, you know, if you want slightly cheaper monthly rates long term, if you want to be able to pay monthly, if you want much better uptime, which obviously is very important, without giving up support, email services, usability, things like that, HostGator might be the better option for you. when it comes to wanting a free domain included for the first year of your hosting, to save you a little money, annual payments, not having to pay every month, free backups, which you can get plugins for that, so really free backups. It shouldn't be the main reason you do either one. Better SEO because of the best SEO plugins, and without giving up support quality, email services, or usability, Bluehost might be your better choice. Okay, so really they're very close. I'm not going to tell you either way which one you should pick because everybody's different. Everybody has different needs. If you're really trying to make a decision, Uptime is very important, but you don't want them to disable your site off of the whim of thinking that you did something that you might not have done with your site. I don't know. When you're sharing servers with other people, things can happen like that where you get your site disabled for a couple days, and a couple days could cost you money. So Bluehost, they'll have more downtime, so it might really even out in the end as far as uptime, downtime, things like that. But chances of you having a problem with them disabling your site on HostGator are probably pretty low. If they do that, it'll, you know, it may happen to you once or twice over a long period of time, but not very often. A free domain can really add up, you know, that can be great. You know, you can save a lot of money through that. And it'll save you a lot of time in the startup process. The better SEO plugins are a big plus, but, you know, like I said, I use both of those plugins, so that was the problem with HostGator, is they didn't really support either one, and it hurt the speed and performance of my site. But there might be some good, I know there are some themes that are SEO supportive, and there are also other plugins that are alternatives of the Yoast SEO plugin and W3 Total Cache. So it might all even out, and you know, it's a tough decision. So I'll leave it up to you whether you think Bluehost or HostGator would be best for you. That's my comparison, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Hope you learned some things about these companies that you didn't already know. And I'll see you in the next video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and let me know in the comments what you thought about the video. I love to hear from you guys and get your opinions on it, or see if you want to add to it. And on top of that, don't forget to visit us at selfmadesuccess.com, and I'll see you in the next video. This is Justin Bryant, and I hope you have a great day.